Good morning. Hi everyone. So myself Maheshiro, today I'm going to explain the problems related to the flexure. In the previous session I explained the theory related to this. Before going to the problems, just I want to brief about the IS 1343-1980 design of prestressed concrete code. Okay, in this flexure, moment of resistance of a rectangular intersection have been discussed. So the moment of resistance for rectangular intersections in which neutral axis lies within the flange. So if the neutral axis lies within the flange, we can use directly the formula M is equal to FPU into AP into D minus 0.4 XU, where M is the moment of resistance of the section and FPU is the ultimate tensile stress in the tendon, AP is the area of pre-tensing tendon, D is the effective depth and X is the neutral axis depth. Okay, from this you have to obtain the effective stress should not be less than 0.45 FP and FP is the artistic strength of the pre-stress steel. Okay, so there is a table number 11 condition at the ultimate limit state for the rectangular beams with pre-tension tendon or with a post-tension tendons having effective bond. Okay, so in this you have to find AP-FP between FCK, that ratio, then depending on that you have to go for stress in the tendon as a portion of the design strength, that is FPU divided by 0.87 FP and XU upon D. So if it be a pre-tension, then you have to go for the values related to this pre-tension. If the beam is post-tension, then you have to go for values related to the post-tension. Okay, so suppose APFP BDFCK is 0.4, then if it is pre-tension beam, then FPU divided by 0.87 FP is 0.9, and similarly XU upon D is, if it is pre-tension, it is 0.837. okay, so we'll go for problems related to this. So problem is, so a pre-stressed concrete beam having a rectangular section 150 mm wide and 350 mm deep has an effective cover of 50 mm if FCK is 40 newton per mm square and FP is 1600 newton per mm square and the area pre-tensioning steel is AP is 461 mm square. Calculate the ultimate flexure strength of the section using 1343 codal provisions. Okay, so FCK, given FCK is 40 newton per mm square, breadth is equal to 150 and FP is equal to 1600 and D is effective to 300 mm and area pre-stressing force is equal to 461 mm square. So next we have to find the effective reinforcement ratio, that is given by FP, AP, FCK and BD. So this will be helpful in the code. So that is AP is 1600 here and FP is 1600, AP is 461, FCK that is 40, it has been given, and breadth is 150 and depth is 300. So it comes to about 0.40. So it is from the table number, not it is 7.1, it is table number 11. Okay, here FPU 0.87, FP is equal to 0.9. So we'll go for that table here from the code. So CAC from the table, this from the disk table, so table number 11. So our effective reinforcement is 0.4, it is a pre-tensioning steel. Okay, so 0.4 is FPU 0.87, FP is 0.9 and XU upon D is 0.783. so here, okay, so see here FPU 0.87.9 and XU upon D is 0.87. okay, so next one, FPU equal to 0.87 into 0.9 into 1000. So you want to find FPU. So 0.9 into multiply by 0.87 into FP. So FPU is 0.87 into 0.9 into 1600, that is 1253 newton per mm square. So similarly, to find x is equal to 0.87 into d, 0.87 into 300, that is 243.9 mm. So mu is equal to FPU AP t minus 0.420 x. Therefore, FPU is equal to here 1253 into 461 into d is 300 minus 0.42 into x is 234.9. Therefore, 116 into 10 to the newton per mm square or 116 kilonewton per meter. Okay. Next problem. A pre-tension T section has a flange which is 300 mm wide and by 200 mm thick. The rib is 150 mm wide by 350 mm deep. The effective depth for the cross section is 500 mm. Given here, rib stressing is 200 mm square, FCK is equal to 50 newton per mm square, and FP is 1600 newton per mm square. Estimate the ultimate moment capacity of the T section using intention at core regulations. So, given FCK is equal to 50 newton per mm square, breadth is equal to 300 mm, FP is equal to 1600 newton per mm square, then depth is equal to 500 mm. And the repressing is equal to 200 mm square. So as we assume that in RCC, so we'll assume that the neutral axis falls within the flange. As it is a T section, it is not rectangular square section. So it the concept of web bind flange. So similarly, when you go for RCC, so we'll be assuming that neutral axis will lie in the flange and neutral axis lies in the web. So here also I will assume as it is a T section, it is lies at the flange. So the value of B is breadth is flange is 300 mm. For computation effective reinforcement ratio, FP AP FCK into BD. So FP equal to 1600 into AP 200, FCK 50 and breadth is 300 and depth is 500. So that comes to about 0.04. So from the table number 11, the corresponding value for the ratio is FPU 0.87 FY, that is equal to 1, and XU upon D is 0.09. Okay, so we'll go for table number 9, that is 0.0. Okay, so here you have to say that is pre-tension T section. Okay, that is 0.04. So we'll go for that code. Where it is, here it is code. So 0.04 you have to go. So after finding this, okay, so in this table you have to go for it. So after finding this, we'll having the values. So 0.04 from the table 11, the corresponding value for ratio is FPU upon 0.87 is 1, XU upon D is 0.09. Therefore, FPU is equal to 0.87 into 1600, that is 1392 Nm square, and XU is equal to 0.09 into 500, that is 45 mm. Okay, so here that in the table you have to go for interpolation here. So the assumption that the neutral axis falls within the flange is correct. So because x is 45 mm and breadth is 300 mm and depth is 500 mm, so it lies within the flange. So the ultimate flexure strength for section is mu is equal to FPU AP d minus 0.420 x, that is 1392 into 200 into 500 minus 0.42 into 45, that comes to about 134.10 newton per mm square. Okay, so this is the interpolation method, how you have to find the interpolation. Okay, from the triangle, smaller triangle to bigger triangle. Okay, so next problem. the prestressed concrete, a prestressed concrete beam, a pre-tensioned beam of rectangular section 400 mm wide by 100 mm or 1000 mm overall depth, replaced by 800 mm high tension steel wires at an eccentricity of 300 mm. If Fk is 14 Nm² and Fp is equal to 1000 Nm², then establish the ultimate flexural strength of this section as far as 1343 total position. So given breadth is equal to 400, depth is equal to 800 mm, area pre-stressing is equal to 800 mm², Fc equal to 14 Nm², Fp is equal to 1600 Nm². So you have to find the effective reinforcement tool, that is therefore effective reinforcement ratio is Fpap divided by Fc to Bd. Fp is 800, here it is 800 and 1600 Fp, then Fck is 40 and breadth is 400 and depth is 800, that is comes to 0.1. then Fpu from the table number 11 and 12 you have to find Fpu. 2.87 is equal to 1, therefore Fpu is equal to 1 into 0.87 into Fp. Okay, therefore 0.87 into Fp is 1600, so it comes to about 1392 Nm², and xu point is 0.217 from the table 11, therefore xu is equal to 0.217 into d, that is effective depth, and 0.17 into 800 is, that is 173.6 mm. Therefore, mu is called Fpu APD minus 0.42 xu, so Fpu 1392 from our calculation. Then AP is 800 and depth is effect of the 800 minus 0.42 into 173.6. So it comes to about 809.6 × 10⁻². Okay. Next one is a pre-tensioned concrete girder of a box. I think it's important for exam. Box section 1 m by 1 m overall dimensions has a uniform wall thickness of 200 mm. The girder is post-tensioned by high tension wires of area 2 to 50 mm² located at an effective depth of 900 mm. If Fck is equal to 14 Nm² and Fp is equal to 1600 Nm², calculate the ultimate flexure strength of the steel girder of the section. Okay, so breadth is equal to given, this is the diagram of that. Okay, so breadth is equal to breadth of the girder 1000 mm. Okay, then overall depth is equal to 1000 mm, then effective depth is equal to 900, then wall thickness is equal to 200 mm, therefore breadth is equal to 1000 mm, Fc equal to 14 Nm², and depth is equal to 900 mm, Fp is equal to 1600 Nm², and area pre-stressing is equal to 2 to 50 mm². Therefore effective reinforcement ratio is APFP divided by BD into Fck, that is equal to AP 2 to 50 into 1600, breadth is 1000 into 900 into 40, that is equal to 0.10. therefore Fp equal to 0.87 into 0.87 into Fck, that is equal to 1. therefore Fp is equal to 0.87 into 1600, 1392 Nm². therefore xu upon d is equal to 0.17. therefore xu is equal to 0.17 into 995.3 mm, that is less than 200 mm. Okay, therefore mu is equal to Fpu APD minus 0.42 into xu. So Fpu is 1392 into AP is 2 to 50 into depth is 900.42 into 195.3. okay, that 2561 kN². Okay, so coming to the next problem. So a post-tensioned beam with the unbonded tendon, it is unbonded, is of rectangular section 400 mm wide with an effective depth of 800 mm. The cross-section area of the pre-stressing steel is 2840 mm². The effective pre-stress in the steel after all losses is 900 Nm². The effective span of the beam is 16 meters. If FCK is equal to 14 Newton per mm square, estimate the ultimate moment of the resistance of the section using 1343 code recommendations. FC equal to 14 and AP is equal to 900 FP is equal to 900, AP is equal to 840 mm square, breadth is equal to 400, depth is equal to 800, L upon D is 15,000 divided by 800 is 20. Then if effective reinforcement ratio is given by, so in this problem you have to find L upon D, unbounded means, okay. So FP, AP, BD and FCK is equal to 900 into 840 divided by 400 into 800 into 40, that is equal to 0.20. From the table number 12, FPU upon FP is equal to 1.16 and XU upon D is 0.58. So XU upon D is 0.58, FP is equal to 1.16 into 900. Okay, that comes to about 1044 Newton per mm square. Therefore, XU is equal to 0.58 into 800, that is 464 mm. Therefore, MU is equal to FPU APD minus 0.40 XU. So FPU is 1044 into APU 2840, depth 800 minus 0.4 and XU. So 1794 and 1066 Newton per mm, Newton mm, or 179.4 kN. Okay. Similarly, here is another one problem. Same thing, it has been there. You have to find L upon D. Okay. After finding, so you have to find AP. So it lies at the web. So in this problem, it lies at the web. So AP is called APW for APF. So APF equal to 0.45 CKB minus BW into ADF divided by FP. So 0.45 into 40 is equal to into 1200 minus 300 into 150 divided by 600. 13,000. So 1518 minus pi. APW is equal to 4000 minus 1518, that is 2482 mm square. So APW into FP, BW into D into FCK is equal to 2482 into 1000 divided by 300 into 1600 into 40, that is 0.129. And FP upon FP is 1.13 and XU upon D is 0.41. Therefore, FP is equal to 1.31 into 1000, okay, that is equal to. And XU is equal to 0.41 into 1600, it comes to about 646 mm, and this comes to about 1310 Newton per mm square. Therefore, MU is equal to FPU, AP, D minus 0.4 and XU plus 0.45 CKB minus PW into DF into D minus 0.5 and DF, okay. So, after calculation, this will get 8011 into 10 Newton mm or 8011 kN. Thank you, okay.